and experiment, you want to leave here at 3 plus 51.
Is that correct? That's from flight, and that, don't forget to push the defender when I go.
Okay. You have it, Bob.
Okay, we got a picture. Okay, we got a picture.
Even sound better. Battery covers are awful dirty, but I will not dust them as long as you're happy.
Yeah, I don't think dusting the battery covers gives us any cooler batteries.
No, we don't need to dust them until we get back.
Well, I know,
but
you keep the batteries from getting dust
in the first place.
I've had pretty good luck with them. They've been pretty clean.
Roger on that.
You are dusted and you're shiny bright all over.
Okay, copy that. We thank you, Ed. Thank you.
And we all thank you. If that Ed thanks me, that's enough. A man could be asserting more than that.
I think your LMP just ran away.
I got my thing. Where'd he go? Jack? What? Oh, there you are. I thought maybe you saw that crater I'm looking at. Okay, I'm going to give you a TTE reading.
Roger, give us a mark.
Now, thunder's beginning to fade, and uh-oh, the clip came off on the inside. That's what's wrong. We'll have to fix that before we start. The outside one's home, but the inside one's not. Bob, all the blocks bigger than 20 centimeters that I've looked at up here are subfloor gabbro in appearance.
Copy that.
I've looked at about 5.
Did we get a mark there on the perimeter, King?
30 seconds to go, Bob.
Roger, I copied it. Just wanted to check.
I copied the flight of this movement.
Okay, Jack, you find anything up there? Gee, I'm going to go up and look at this one rod. Why don't you set up and sample any one of these other big ones? They're all the same. Like the one near the rover. And I'll go up and try to get this big one down there. Well, okay. It's the only one left to look at, but right now we're dealing with subfloor material, I think. What about some of these little fragments that seem to be sitting more on the surface?
Yeah, we're supposed to rake here. We'll get those at the rake.
That one up there, by the way, is sitting on the surface.
Yeah,
it's either submerged. That's why I want to look at it. If you, you don't have a hammer, but if you need me, I'll come up there, because I think that may be worthwhile.
I'll roll it down to you.
I'll roll it down to you.
Yeah.
Thanks a lot.
Reminder 17, we'd like to have you leaving here in 30 minutes to make up some of the time we spend at station 6 and 7 a little extra. And we'd also remind you that we'd like a rake soil sample here too. That may be the only way we try and pick up some stuff if, other than sub 4, but if that indeed has come down from the top of the sculptured hills.
Okay, Bob, this rock is a big chunk of scattered but still visible bluish gray anorthosite. It's glass coated and it actually looks like it's vesicular. I'm going to roll it downhill so we can work on it. Well, I'll document it first. Copy that.
Roger, I copy that. We'll be watching it coming.
Okay, but the point is, as Gene said, it's the only rock, big one anyway, in the area that I see that's perched on the surface as if it might have rolled here.
Okay, copy that, Jack.
But I don't see a track. Man, this one here is tough as a... Well, we can get some following. Yeah, that's what I'm going to do. I tell you, this one is so... I thought you might be able to break up. Yeah, there's no corners on it. For this?
We're ready.
Bob, 563 is the sample.
Copy, 563.
Over here to the, are you ready?
Over.
Are you ready for this? I'm not sure I am, but go ahead. Go, roll! Look, I would roll on this slope. Why don't you? 5-6 gravity that's missing. Hey, I bet you they would like if I didn't step on it. Trample out of the bottom of that thing. Yep. These others all look to your right, Jack. They look like what we've been sampling. And they're all pretty well mantled, except the one you got up there. There's one more piece I see in the side of that crater that may not be. Bag 545 will be soil from under that anorthosite boulder. Bob, the only thing that bothers me about that boulder being subfloor, I mean sculptured hills, is that it's glass coated.
I'll do that.
It may have been thrown in here by an impact. Oh, you're here. Well, let's sample it, then roll it down.
Well, okay, I never would have moved it if I thought you were coming up.
Well, I wasn't coming up, but I looked at some of those others. There's only one more.
Okay.
Well, I got it documented up in place. I think that's the side that was down. Let me roll it over. Let me get a piece of that side since it was underneath, and we'll roll it over and get a piece of the other side.
Good thinking. Okay, yeah, let's do it again. Except I got dust all over it.
Albedo.
The downside picture's not gonna mean much. Let me get this sample in your bag. Wait, I think we ought to change your bag because stuff's gonna start flying out, but it won't stay closed.
Jack, after this one, there's one more in that crater. Maybe from that crater, but I don't know.
How's your hand for hammering?
This will be easy. The old hammer in hand, this will be an easy one.
Flight class.
Go ahead, Sam.
The most important thing here really is that rake sample, so to preclude being caught up against no time, we'd like to make sure that at least one of us has a rake, and then we can always...
It's stained by that glass coat. That's a pretty one, isn't it?
Yeah, what you're essentially saying is, we'll take my hand. Gambro. We got the soil here. We'll get some samples off of this inorthic site.
Thank you.
And then get the rakes.
Oh, yeah, I'm going to chop another piece off.
Yeah, there's a trench involved here too, but many times we do document a sample and then we don't get a chance to do the rake.
There's
something we should be doing.
Roger.
We have three pieces laying around.
That's a fine thing here, if we can't find anything else to do.
Right.
Let's get those before we lose them.
Bag
564.
The CDR's SCB-7 is getting off the floor.
Maybe.
I think it'd be a good idea to put it under the LNP's feet and let the CDR down.
I got it.
SCB-5.
Oh, you already got him in the bag?
Okay. Okay, we'll ask him.
We copy 564 okay. From the bottom of the Volga.
Sure, at the bottom, huh?
Yeah.
Sure, at the bottom, huh?
Yeah,
it's good. Mixed with local soil. I'm pretty sure. Let's turn it over. I recognize it. Although it's got dust all over it. I gotta get one more swab off there. I don't want to do this. Let me get another swab off there. I can get it. Okay.
About 18 minute drive.
Hey, let me roll it over. Go ahead, want to put it in?
Yeah.
Okay. Oh boy. My partially print run, it's probably the average grain size will turn out to be about 3 or 4 millimeters, maybe half a centimeter. Oh, it's not. I got a couple pictures. We really cut that one messed up.
Yeah,
that's all right. You hold your scoop where that one came off, it'd help. Yeah, just going over.
On another side.
Going over there. This side is clear. The last one I took off. Okay, right there. Okay, that's good. Let's move to Noman. We won't roll it over on the Noman.
Flight experiments.
Go ahead.
Now, can we get him to check that last bag number? What do you think we've used that one before?
Yep, put them both in the same bag. They're both off in the bottom of the truck.
Okay.
Oh, yeah, that other side is the one that was up. Well, I'm not sure now. Got so much dust on it. Let's,
experience, Mike. You know what they're trying to do with that, right?
They're talking a hole down that hill, unless we got it on edge. No.
Looks like
they come up here.
Yeah.
Well, maybe
they're
trying
to roll
it. It's good, huh? Yeah.
I think
what side was the glass on when you looked at it? It's on all sides. On all sides.
17, there's probably not much point in spending a lot of time in here trying to decide which is the top. It's not big enough anyway, really, to worry about the top and bottom samples that are radiologically significant.
Well, that's, if you don't want another sample, then we can go ahead. Well, let me get the piece of this call.
Wonderful.
Very well.
Science, right?
Well, that.
Want to press on and leave the rocker or what?
Science, Mike. Go ahead, Flat.
There it is.
You want to go ahead and get this more sample here off this rocker? Or you want to leave it?
Okay. Let me try to get
them. We'd like.
They got it.
Yeah, we'd like to get them over to the crater ramp.
Put them in here. Okay, a piece of the glass from it, Bob, is 546.
Okay, we've got
a local soil.
And now we're ready for you guys
okay,
to rake. And I guess I suggest a crater rim if possible. Probably over there near the rover.
Okay, now you got a sample of that big block down there, huh?
Yeah.
Okay. Don't forget your Nomen. Woo! Oh, boy. Bob, I'm on Frank Comp 85.
Copy 85 for the commander.
85 for the commander. Too bad I don't have my skis. Dad, did you get a fan up here?
No.
I'll get one. Good. I forgot. I got instant skiing. Can't keep my edges. A little hard to get a good hip rotation. Let's see, I must be looking back at this swap. Let's see, I must be looking back at this swap. Golly, I don't know. I'm looking back at the complex, Cochise and Shakespeare, and I can see the limb. Hey Bob, one interesting thing up here, you can see the erosional pattern of the talus, the mantle that, I call it a mantle, but the talus that's on the sculptured hills. There's little boulder tracks of all sizes from all these little clods, and they all, of course, point downhill or nearly downhill.
Okay, copy that.
Hey Bob, in the interest of time, I'll document this without the Nomen.
Okay, I presume Dean cut the Nomen up there.
So we concur with that.
Yeah, I should have brought it.
Okay, don't forget the Nomen, Dean.
Brought it.
And we concur with documenting
don't
without the Nomen.
Nomen. Whee! Boy, when you do this, then you go down slope. That first up is a long one.
I'm having.
This is the best way for me to travel, uphill or downhill.
What's that?
Like this, two-legged hop.
There seems, yeah.
Then on level ground, I can skip. I don't like that loping thing.
Oh, the loping's the only way to go.
See,
when I'm on level ground, I can skip. But this two-legged thing is great. Man, I cover ground like a kangaroo. Oh, okay.
You documented already. I'm just going to put this in the field of view anyway.
You're on the after wing, haven't you? You're on the after wing, haven't you?
Okay, experiments, what are we going to do about the step at the end of this station?
Get a reading.
Get a temp reading and then what?
I'll close it back up. You don't plan to run it until you get to station 10, is that right?
Well, anything about that.
Well, if it's below 108, turn it on. Try to run as long as we can.
Man, it's just nothing.
If it's below 108, there you'll
run. It's mantled with Taylor's. Well, it is, because that downhill pattern goes right down the slope of this crater, and actually, it goes upslope of the crater.
If it's above that, well, there's no point in running it.
This may be on a ray somewhere. Because it goes right downhill with little...
DSCA out here.
Any boulder trail pattern. It goes right up the slope.
I think those are later in the crater by a long ways.
Did you sample anything over here?
No, I haven't done anything.
I'm going to pick up the piece out of that little...
Good
crater.
Put your Norman over there?
No, I'll just take it to it. Let me know when you're ready for a bag.
Hell, I'm not ready.
You're about ready?
Yep.
Okay. I raked about a 2 meter square area, maybe, about 2 meters, and down to 4 or 5 centimeters for these. Pretty good population.
They're all in blend?
They're all in. 5, 6, 5.
Okay, copy that.
Sounds great.
Sounds like a good rake sample for a change.
Yeah, sir.
And this is a kilogram soil location, fellas.
Yes, sir. That gear bag is full. We're going to almost, no, it didn't, but we're going to change it when we get back there anyway. That one ought to go into your seat.
Well, okay.
Get your kilogram, I'll be ready to take it. Kilograms in 566.
Copy that. And remaining here, we'd have primarily a trench. If you fellows think it's feasible, we'd like to be moving in 1 minute, 11 minutes. And we could use a pan from this lower location.
Let's just go back and take a trench and
turn over.
Roger, that sounds good to us.
Okay.
And we also remind you to remember the scan
and figure
that
the
Okay. Yeah, good point.
I'll get the sample here that I got documented now.
Is that all going to go in there?
Yeah.
Okay. Can you twist it?
Check time. We need to allow time to put
if you won't put a rock, we have been too much.
Yep.
Take that rock out. If it's
not, it'll stay.
Take that rock out. If it's
not, it'll stay.
You're gonna have to put it in mine now. Yeah, let me try since we're gonna unload your bag. This may be the last one. That's the last one for your bag.
Okay.
Okay. Did you get anything out of that little crater?
No, but I'm running right now.
Okay. Why don't you get your after picture over there and go down and get that trench. I'll come down.
You don't want a bag, okay.
I can bag it. I can do it.
All right, myself, sir.
Pure white and very friable. Oh boy, is it? Pure white. Right out of a small little pit crater on the side of this crater I just walked in, Houston. And it's pure white, very friable. I got about, one big piece and several small in 5, 6, 7.
Copy that.
Bob, the walls of these craters, big craters around here, that is the ones that are, say, 15 meters in diameter, tend to be a little bit lighter albedo than ones down in the mantle area. I'm afraid those pictures on that rake maybe a little bit, maybe through a dust-colored lens. Now, they were also in my documented sample here, too. Okay, where do you want this trench? On the side of this crater?
Well,
I'll drop my note.
I don't know. I don't, I'm just thinking about that. I think we ought to get out in the inner crater area to see if there's any, stratigraphy to whatever the talus is.
Okay, Jack. I'm going to, leave the Norman right here.
I get it.
And while you're digging that trench, we've got the pan to get, but I want to fix this fender.
I guess it's the pan's mine, isn't it?
Yeah, it is, and I want to fix the fender before before we leave.
Okay, we agree with that. You might get us a
one, and I'll take.
You might get us your perimeter reading there, Gene, while you're at it. And if you have time, you might drop the perimeter on the ground, and we will get a reading with it on the ground as well.
Holy smoly. Holy smoly.
Perimeter is coming up.
670-096-001. 670-096-001.
Copy that.
You want it dropped on the ground, huh?
Gently.
Gently. I can't find a general level spot, but I'll level it. If it takes pictures, does its thing on a rover, it'll do its thing here.
Yeah, just have to get us that
okay,
check.
Okay, Mark.
Copy that.
Fender fixing time, it's camera taking off time. And I think I'll zap myself in a little cool water.
How's the trench going, Jack?
Hold down. Oh man, I tell you, when you call for cold water, they did come in nicely. Woo! I'm really happy with this fender. Really happy with it. Bob, I have gotten a wall now in one place that's standing about 25 centimeters high, and it shows no apparent change in the texture of the soil to that depth, except possibly at the lower 5 centimeters. There's some zones that might be slightly more granular. Particle size may be up a little bit.
Okay, I copy that. Probably just 3 samples, that'll be sufficient then.
I think so. Maybe 4.
Be there in a minute, Jack. Be there in a minute, Jack.
Oh, that's all right. I can probably get started.
Oh. Well, we sure given his suspension system will work out.
Whew. I can even see it.
Getting awful dusty.
Boy, everything is stiff.
Everything is just full of dust. There's got to be a point where the dust just overtakes you and everything mechanical quits moving. Like scoops. I'm not sure whether Detroit would like the fender, but it'll sure buy the fix. Okay, it's fixed.
Okay, copy that.
And I'm happy. I like it.
Roger, we copy that. We'll copy it again. And we'd like to have you guys move it in about 3 minutes.
Good luck. You need me to help you get bagged those samples, huh?
Yes, sir, I think I do. I can't adjust my scoop to my self-bagging method.
Let me get back on some lighter cooling here, too.
To save some water. Okay, now.
Okay, the bottom 10 centimeters.
I get your bags. I left my camera off when I was
a, It's very much like the surface we're standing on, except it clouds up quite a bit more. Can you tell anything from the trench itself?
I told him. I talked to him a little about it.
Okay.
It looked a little more, a little coarser grain, but that's all.
Okay. It sure holds a nice wall, though.
Yep.
That's the kind of wall I expect those quartz cells.
You got another one?
Okay, skim of the upper. We'll see how well I do. Skim sample of the upper half centimeter. Maybe a centimeter deep.
Okay, can you hold it? No, I'm going to put it in your bag. Is it going to fit in there?
Well, there's no choice right now. Let me,
I think a little one's going to fit in there.
Be by, I want to put this one in there too. That's in bag 549.
Copy that.
Try again. Okay, the upper, below that skim, the next 5 centimeters.
Put it down, you know.
I just put it over it.
Yeah. I can't turn it. Five, 5-0.
Copy that.
And the next 10 centimeters down. Can you get this one too?
Yep.
I gotta get your bag.
Okay.
Okay, that was the next 10 centimeters. And then the first sample, of course, was the 10 centimeters below that. And the last bag is 551.
Okay, copy that. We're ready for you guys to move out.
Okay. You didn't get a pan here. While I point out the rover, you got a. I'll get your amper in the trench and a pan.
I will.
I'll get the TG and clean up the rover.
That's the firm. We agree with that.
What's the key that keep getting keyed? It sounds like Bob stepping on his foot, Mike.
Yeah, he's so excited.
Okay, he can't stand it. You done with the Nomen?
Yep.
Okay. I'll get the pan. Get your pan and I'll get the TG and clean up.
Wait, you took a pan up the hill there.
Yeah, I took it way up there.
Okay. I'll take it right here then.
Uh-oh.
What?
Sample came out.
The sample came out?
I'll pick it up.
Yeah, your top came open. It's awful full, Jack. If you can't get it, I'll get it with the top.
Go ahead and go to work, and I'll get the pan first. I lost two of them, I guess.
Yeah, those are the last two I put in there. They just, your bag is so full, they won't stay. Let me get my reading here.
EVA, fine.
Hey, Bob, can I move it on a rover and then give you a reading?
Yes.
As long as you're careful not to hit the button while you're doing it.
Yes.
As long as you're careful not to hit the button while you're doing it.
I don't want to hit the button. It's easier to do it that way. I don't know why I asked you. I know I can. Even this thing doesn't want to go on. It's so dusty. Okay, it's on and it's locked. And here's your reading. 670 670 117 301. That's 670 117 301.
Okay, we copy that.
I got a descent tick next time around. Jack, we gotta do some bag changing here.
Yep.
I'll get those things with my tar on if you can't get them. You have to bend over.
EVA,
every time you jump around.
Like the LMP bag goes over. Okay, if that's the case, the only bag we have is the big bag that's on the back of the geology pallet that will fit the cliff, however.
Okay. I didn't take them back there. Put them under the seat.
Okay.
Need to take that one?
No, I got it. Okay. All right, EVA. Go ahead. They do have SCB-3, which is the LRE sample bag, a standard SCB up on the accessory staff. They can just take that off the handhold and put it right on the LRE list. If they take any more LRE samples, they can just drop them in the floor.
Bam!
You got another one dropped there, Jim. A Jack cut it.
Another one?
Jack's getting it.
Okay.
YDVA.
Jack, we got to place there. I have a full bag.
I mean,
put a small can over there.
We've also
got two over there.
Clips on the back.
That was sample.
So,
let me take your bag off first.
Take that charge and put it in the seat.
Okay, well, you might as well fill it as well.
Yeah, I am.
Okay. Holy hell. Turn to the left.
And flight EVA. One more quick. If we're including the gravimeter in our final closeout timeline, we suggest getting back at 5+40 with the procedures that have been presented.
Your bag isn't in much better shape.
We'd like to have you check this bag. I put them both under the seat there.
Well,
we're running out of bags.
Okay, we got nine bags left. We should have
that. It was on the gate, right? Okay. Well, we had it under seat. Okay, bag number four is absolutely full. And it's under Jack's seat.
Okay, I suggest you take the other bag that's on the gate there and put that on either you or Jack. And also the commander's bag is pretty full also, we suspect.
Why don't you put it on me? Mine gets full faster. Somehow.
You might check team's bag anyway.
Somehow.
You might check team's bag anyway.
Stay there. I'm trying to get the bottom part. I checked in. He's got about six... samples to go.
Okay. And
I just want to be sure that it's locked down.
Okay.
Science flight.
Now turn on left so I can get the other hook ahead.
Yeah, I've just got an answer from the EVA.
Okay, that's not coming out, I guarantee you that.
LAD 5 is on the LFT.
Planning.
Okay,
cut
it up.
Nothing on the gate.
Okay,
5
plus
40.
Yeah, we got that.
Fine. Yeah, I think that'll stay down.
But it's not ready.
Okay,
sure.
I got one more
to
do.
We're working on a big bag now to get some time.
Let me leave it on the gate.
Put a bag around it.
It's got a bag around.
Okay, and Jack, while Dean's doing that, why don't you read the set temperature? Somebody read the set temperature anyway and close the blankets.
Okay, I'll do that. Okay, Bob, let's see, you got your readings? 120, Bob, 120.
Copy, 120.
Coast blankets just aren't being closed.
Flooding, come. This would be a good time.
Okay, I guess we're headed ready to head on out. You're free?
Okay, and Dean, when you go to change the LCRU, we'd like you to just turn it to off, OSF, on the power switch, the internal power external switch. And we'll be reading you through the lens a chance to cool down the LCRU on the way home to Station 9.
All right.
Experiments, like.
In Houston, what's the temperature limit on the DSEA?
Right. Stand by, Jack.
What was his question?
What's the temperature limit on DSEA?
We're not going to pull DSEA.
It looks like shock.
We're waiting on a word from experiments whether to do it here or Station 10.
Not a glass planted on some of these, Jack. Yep.
The temperature is getting pretty high, and then I had to get it out of there. But don't tell anybody. Okay, last I heard from experiments, they're waiting for all station 10 if they're waiting. Block E. You want it down there? Woo! Yeah, perimeter. Okay, copy. Bob?
This is the only clearly, I wouldn't even say that, this is at least a large blocky rim crater. But even it has the metal dust material covering the rim, partially burying the rocks, and it's down on the floor, as near as I can tell. And on the walls. The crater itself has a central mound of blocks that's probably 50 meters in diameter. That's a little high. 30 meters in diameter. Many of the blocks are holy smoly, intensely shattered in that area as the ones that are on the walls. I don't see any sign of organization of the blocks in the walls right now. There's a possibility that on the west wall there's a indication that there's slightly darker gray rocks starting about halfway down the crater, and that level is coincident with what appears to be a bench on the northwest wall. And that bench, the hints of that bench, it's not continuous, but hints of it are around on the north wall and I think right below it, yeah. On the southeast wall. The, we'll start. The rocks are pretty badly broken in many cases. And, I haven't seen any real glass yet. Yes. We'll start looking at them a little more carefully. Some of them look, that looks like a breccia right there.
Well, yeah, there's some interesting patterns on the surface.
Stand by. Wait. Stand by. Wait. Okay. Ah. Sorry, Gino, but, okay. Locator. But I haven't been doing my duty on locators occasionally.
Mark, 3 minutes.
Get that? Yep, I got it. Okay, Gene's tearing apart one of the very intensely fractured rocks. And it comes off in small flakes. Let's get this one because this will be the best oriented one for documentation. Plus, why don't you get that one you got inside there?
Yeah, I have.
Got a bag? Bag 568. Is a fragment from the surface. And that's a corner, I think, off the block that Gene documented here.
And
we'll get another sample. That'll be from inside the block.
Get it with this relay. Yeah.
Here's the whole big
block like that just as is.
Well, put a bag around if we, about one end if we can.
Yeah, the other end is smaller.
Let me hold this end.
Let me hold this bag on.
Go ahead.
That's a wrench job too. That's see the white fragment?
Yeah,
it certainly got a lot of earth. It looks like this big one over here. You know, it might be that the These might be pieces of the projectile. I don't know.
Because
that looks like it's not stuff for.
I don't think we're going to have time to get away from here in 15 minutes to get your tilt reverberator readings.
Now, that's wrapped in. If you put it in down, it may stay in the bag.
It has to be here. We can attempt it again.
I doubt it.
At,
what's the number?
GMB.
It's a highly friable. It breaks apart. Yeah, not so much. In small chips. Well, you did it with your hands there. I call that being friable. Compared to what we've seen, anyway. Okay, let me get an after. Let me get a soil right over here.
Copy that.
A lot of these blocks up here, Houston, are particularly the more fractured ones, but even some that aren't, Gray matrix record breaker.
Go ahead.
And it looks like
I guess about 5 minutes.
Okay, really the frameworks are quite fine. There's no on the rim anyway, we haven't seen any large fragments. The largest I've seen is about 2 centimeters. But down in the mile,
yeah, we'll
you can see some fragments that are probably half a meter in diameter. Jack, are you going around that rim of the crater up there? I was just looking at rocks. Well, okay. We need to see if we can get some of the subfloor. I'm not sure I understand what's
going on. We got to leave here now and come back to the river.
This should have brought up subfloor according to the theory.
That's just like
some of the, look at some of the bridges, the blue bridges with the white, big old flabby white,
we're going to take
the fracture face with the
inclusion.
Yeah, down in the forest, it has that appearance, all right. Do you see that rock? That rock that's fractured in sort of a pyramid shape down there? Out here on the right,
this is
right
high. This is like the two close out that used that time to take it out now.
That's the unique fracture.
Look at the time. Roger.
There's another one that fractured.
We'd like to get away from here in about 10 minutes, so we probably better be trending back towards the rover unless you're seeing something really great out there.
Well, hey, Bob, we ought to find out whether or not we got whether. What the rock is here,
We got 10 minutes.
Can you come over here? I think there's some subfloor here. We ought to try to document it, but I tell you, most of the rocks are the fine fragment wrenches.
Let me see if I can't get one of those.
There's some glass.
Hey, you see if they're like Bailey's,
okay.
Well, they're eyeballs or whatever they are.
I think we can get some over here. If you're careful coming over here, we can get glass that looks like it may have crystallized in place there.
Okay. I'm talking about those little balls, too.
See that? Whoa, right. Whoa, take it easy.
Oh, you're right there?
Yeah, but put your Norman right over here, and we can get that for glass and that for subfloor.
Okay, let me,
But I'm not sure that is. Maybe, Brecher, everything is covered with dust here, and it's hard to tell the types. Most of the rocks we're seeing are breches.
I'll fly the camera.
Make sure that glass is material.
As far as I know, there's no input that says that we're going to hurt anything by doing it here, so I prefer to do it. The temperature under the CDR seats is well below 100 degrees.
Be careful with it.
Okay. Into what?
Go
ahead. So which direction are we looking at now, Jim?
Maybe I'll find out for
you. I don't have any bags, so...
Yeah. Okay, the glass... looks like a glass of glutamate.
Good. That's 4.5 and sideways.
Oh, no.
Okay.
Didn't break. Good. I think that'll survive going back now. Okay, it's a frothy glass of glutamate. It's going to be in bag 481.
Copy that.
And it looks like, almost like a calpi type of bomb, Bob, if you'll pardon the expression. And it looks like, almost like a calpi type of bomb, Bob, if you'll pardon the expression.
I will, I don't know what everybody else.
It's an aggregate of glass it's a pile of about 4 fragments, much like the one we're sampling. Jack, we want to get a good scoop sample here. Maybe we get some of those little fine pieces of glass around.
And it looks like it's in place from the one day it was born.
Copy that.
Oh, God, bingo. I'm having a hard time with this one.
Let him go.
The piece of that rock right behind it.
Science. Okay, do we want to do the rover sample here, or we're going to drop that and just look for these white rocks on the way back here, over.
Put it back.
Stand by, flight.
Yep. You're, just not going to be able to get that one in the bag.
Northwest. Second?
Looking northwest.
Thank you.
Flight, we want the radio sample, and we'll take that cut off.
You want the radio
sample? Okay, Houston, my sample's in,
copy.
482 is, rock, but it doesn't look like subfloor. It looks like a blue-gray material we've been seeing, a breccia-type material.
Fine, EVA.
Yeah.
Right.
I don't think there's any difference.
I'll give you about 6 minutes to do.
Got it in. My sample's broke in my bag.
Go ahead, flight.
You're willing to take that time out of station 10, I guess.
That's firm.
Okay.
Okay.
There's a lot of scoop out here, though, Jack.
So, why don't we get that scoop sample as the first sample of Jack's radio sample, 17.
Okay, that's right. You're getting a radio sample. That's fine.
Go. I forgot to remind you when the DSC-8 comes out here.
Oh, man. That's right. You're going to
see under my flap 500 millimeter cameras under.
Okay.
That runs a nominal 75 degrees Fahrenheit.
Oh, boy. Okay, let's let that be the one. Yeah, here's one.
Well, okay. Those are the last ones that you can take. Going to lock? No, I don't. See them, I... Look at all that. Okay. Okay, before you go back, I got an answer picture here. And I want to get a pan of this thing. We get a stereo pan as you start your radio sample. But you take the answer from there, and I'll go over here and city hopping over here, Landale. Da 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 da. Da 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 da. Bob, would you tell me what your primary desires are again on the 500, based upon what we have?
Okay, the primary desire being the north and the east, the blocks and the trails.
Okay.
And while you're at the rover, they want you to take the gravimeter off again, and we'll get another rover and another surface measurement here as well to check against the rover.
Okay. Here's the reading. I think I owe you one of those, don't I?
Roger.
670-037-801. 670-037-801.
Copy that. Flight's kept on.
So we're going to do both of these because we're going to do one or the other.
Targets. There's no way we're going to get it right from here anywhere near on time.
We're already late. Yeah, we're already late, and if we don't leave here by about 4 plus 5, 5, we aren't going to get any time at 10 that mounts anything. That's about 15 minutes.
Well, you'll be lucky to get away from here at 5.
That's right.
The 50 it looks like 10.
Looks like
hey, back.
Flight EVA.
Good.
10 down the drain. We need a bearing range for EP5 to
5. 52 Yankee. is at the rim crest.
Copy that. Copy that.
AI experiment flight. Go ahead.
Well, I'll tell you what I'm going to do.
We got a bag up there that doesn't agree with what EVA is.
Use the rover to study the 500, see what happens.
Yeah, sample thing. A magazine. Bravo is what we were planning to put on. Flight experience guide. Last time we can leave here and deploy that charge and get back to the limit. 5 + 4.0 is 5 + 1.5.
Okay.
You have given up station 2.
No, I should have let you take the scoop back.
Oh, no. We're working on that flight business class.
Okay. Tell me. Well, shoot.
I don't think we have a choice.
This isn't working out too well, Dr. Parker.
Okay.
Call me. Well, shoot.
I don't think we have a choice.
This isn't working out too well, Dr. Parker.
Say again there, Jack.
Well, I gotta get rid of this scoop. Just set it there and take your sample, we'll get it. I think the sample's going back.
Are they discussing whether they're going to get out of here fast or they're going to stay here forever? For 5:15.
They're trying to salvage.
It's like a training. The scoop doesn't stay locked to the station.
Okay, you want to press on though with the station, as is. They're both back at the rover now if you want to get out of here.
Well, what's that left to do? Got to take the DSEA out. Yeah, we've got to take the DSEA and that's it.
We're
in normal stuff.
We're in opportune time right now for to get out if they want to get out.
Okay, let's leave. We take the DSEA out and we'll leave and get it because I'm going to read and we'll go.
Okay, in other words, we're going to abort the radial sample. Is that affirmative?
That's right.
Okay. Okay, 17, we'd like you to press on. We'll abort the radial sample. We'd like to leave here immediately, if not sooner, to head for station 10. Enough of the 500 millimeters, Gene. And we'll give you some information here on mag.
I'd like to use that same
We need the zero foot path on the rover. If you haven't already, if it's on the ground, we didn't get the mark, but it's probably done by now. And we're going to take the DSEA out of the tape recorder here, and we'd like to get that all done pronto.
Okay, 85 is a
MATCON
on the 500.
Copy, 85
and a 500. I think that's a smart move, Bob. I don't think the radio sample's going to tell you much here.
Okay, let's take a... Go ahead. So we're going to use Bravo or Delta on the commander's camera.
Bravo.
Jack, got to get a scoop of that first, though. Well, there's one scoop. We don't have a scoop of it, do we? Look what's underneath it.
Well, I don't know what's underneath.
It's white. Well, I want to make sure I got some small glass balls. We'll get a scoop.
White glass, we've got a charge.
17, we're anxious for you guys to get going.
We'll get a scoop.
White glass, we've got a charge.
17, we're anxious for you guys to get going.
Okay, here's your gravimeter reading from the surface. 670057101. 16705-0571-101.
Copy that.
Want me to check my mag at the next station?
Go ahead, Gene. Quickly.
588. Yeah, CDR.
Things about being tired. Hands being tired. I really feel that we ought to try to hold it to 7.
483.
Copy, 483.
Okay, well, nothing I can say right now is, well, let's just keep on trying with the plan. If we run out of time for 10, we'll just stop and keep going. And if we do, we'll just do what we can.
Okay.
In 484.
Get some?
I got quite a bit.
That's enough.
I got quite a bit.
There, you gotta put that away, don't you?
And the next 10 centimeters of the light gray material be in probably in 486.
5EVA.
So lucky.
The CDR's got only two pictures that he takes.
They're off.
Off the LRV seat.
I think it is 40.
So that's right.
Yep. 45.
45, okay.
So we ought to do it here.
That's what
I say. 43, 44, okay. You with us, Bob?
Roger, we're with you.
He's mad at us now.
You got
it. Hey, the third sample's in 485.
Copy that.
Okay. Oops, sorry. Bob, a possibility here is that the this upper 6 inches of gray material in here is the latest mantling in the area, and the light colored debris may be what's left over from the impact.
Okay, I copy. I understand. But we'd like to get you going. Case you didn't get the clue.
No, just go on. Okay.
Okay, I copy. I understand. But we'd like to get you going. He didn't get the clue.
No. Look on. Okay. All right, put it off.
Taking off the DMPA here.
Well, we'll send you at the next station. Is that right, Bob? No, I got to have some.
That's fine.
I got to get some. I can't take
Okay, 17. We need Jack to put on magazine Nancy. And we'd like Gene for you to pull out the DSEA tape recorder at this station.
Okay, I need a magazine too, Bob. I don't have any film at all.
Roger, that'll be Bravo if you change your ear. You could change it to station 10.
Yeah, I'll grab change
it here. Just as easy while we're in there.
Okay.
Okay, you want Bravo, huh?
Bravo. I'll get the tape, I'll get the DFDA. Bravo was outside there, I thought. There you go.
Let me get this. Hold it one far enough. Let me get this. I can get rid of this all at one time.
Well,
that's
right.
Go ahead, Sam.
Okay, it's apparent that we can't get the cat. We're going to do a double core here and just go back to the lambda with the stop of ET5.
We lost the dark light on a Bravo and it's a
double core.
It's in the dirt. I'm not going to pick it up.
Plus.
All right, copy that. There's no point for the fact
that
we're
going to
go anyway.
Time back to the left.
Well, we won't call it.
They don't know. We get another shot. Got all the crew ahead.
Okay. Science wants to
get up. Okay, we're done with the step. DSTA is coming out.
Station 10 and do a double core here. We have to leave at 5:15 to get back in land by 5:40. Science, does that allow time to deploy this these explosive charges anywhere?
Yeah, so we can drop off EP-5 on the way in.
Okay, logical, that kind of thing.
Okay, they want a double core here. In place of we're not going to do station 10. By skipping station 10, we can leave here about 10 minutes from now and get back in time.
Okay, so we're going to change that all around again and go to station, not go to station 10. We'll go to double core here.
That's
we'll start,
right.
The bomb, start the bomb off the way in.
That's right. Flight experiments?
I got it.
We have two more charges.
We got two at SCP, including
we can put this EP-5 out right here with a range of 2.3. We can say that stop.
We're going to change the hunt here again as usual. And we're going to drop station 10, now that we've heard you so much, and we're going to get a double core here. And we'd like to get the some football size rocks while you're doing that, but double core here. And then we're going to leave here and go to the LM.
You don't want a double core here? I don't think we can do it, Bob. It's too rocky. You think we get through that stuff you just trenched? Well, I'm afraid there are rocks all through it, gee. We can try, Well, I don't like to try things that there's a probability of failure on. If you can step, you're just going to lose some time. Okay, Mag Nancy's on the LMP's camera.
Copy that.
Flight experiments, go ahead. We didn't get a step. We would like a step temperature reading, final one, for know what temperature it was.
Instance,
pull it out.
You can see the rock population here, Houston.
We can try it.
Okay, we have to have you guys moving in 10 minutes, and we'd like to also deploy EP number 5 here.
Okay. I'll start up.
Okay,
what is the lower 5? This is the lower, right?
Yeah.
You got a number?
Yeah.
Let's get 5 out now, start on the core. I'll put that right there. Okay, the lower is 5-0, the upper is 3-7.
Copy, 5-0 and 3-7.
Is that 5, Jack?
Yep.
Okay. Let you, put it up, well, you put the Norman away. Put it right in here, that trench. At least there's some documentation. I'll try to have the pan going while you're doing it.
When Gene's doing the double core, the
next thing you have
to do is do the
drive out of here.
SCLC, all pickups.
I'm driving out of here, left or right? I gotta go right, okay? Bin 1 is pulled and safe. Bin 2 is pulled, safe. Bin 3 is pulled and safe.
Okay, Jack, and we're talking that back to the rover, I guess, is the best way. That doesn't look too hard, Gene. Until just now.
It's like you... Looks like you proved me wrong. That first quarter was easy. Second one a little tougher, and it got tough on at the end. Stay there, I'm getting a picture of you. Okay?
Okay.
I got it. You got it, Tony? Okay.
Yeah.
Is the DSEA is now under the seat. There's a gigantic thermal
power. Oh, man, even these pins are
well, that's where we told him to put it.
Okay, Bob, the top ramp down, almost halfway without any effort.
Copy that.
Coop's back on.
The bomb ran down about an inch.
Copy that.
Okay, Robert, let's see.
Turn around, I get this.
What was the last thing, we had to do?
A couple football-sized rocks.
You got the DSEA?
I got it.
I got the charge, you got the double core.
I got the double core.
And I got one sample of a radio sample.
We got that's a unique one.
In my pocket.
And we got the,
Music with depth. I hadn't really noticed that before.
Okay, we copy that. Really noticed.
It's quite a bit more cohesive, but, feels about the same down to 3 centimeters out here. And then the cohesion goes up, so it's,
Captain, you need to remind him about that camera change, yeah?
Yeah, that'll be a while. Okay.
Okay, Bob, the core tubes are going in SCV-7. I mean, yeah, 7.
Okay, I copy that.
Okay, should have TV, Bob.
Right, we have TV. Thank you.
Did you get my bag already?
Yep.
Jack, we'll have one more to put in here. I'm just going to lay this over here.
And yeah,
there's some big ones in there, yeah, too.
Is that where you expected to?
You can get some of this stuff for.
Yeah. Say again?
There's one in my footpan, too. You see it there? Yeah.
Roger, VA.
Okay, we'd like to take PGE, of course, as we plan, take it off. We'll try and get both the grab advisory. You might initiate one of them now. We'll initiate another one later on. We got plenty of time while we're sitting on the ground there to do our thing with it.
And a commander should expect a feed water zone.
Are you going to have a feed water zone coming up pretty soon, Gene?
Bob, I already got it, and I'm in auto. Just about 30 seconds ago.
Okay.
We copy that.
Okay, how we fix, for example, here's 5.
Get in.
And it's about half to three quarters full. Well, let's dump, we got to carry the SESC up. Let's dump these, I've got three in there. They're over sampling. Okay. Okay.
Let's put the SESC someplace where it's accessible to get that contamination sample. We probably want to get it before they go off to the outset, but there's no real hurry on that. We'll see what works in best. I'm not sure where the most convenient place would be to put it.
Well, we get it now. We get the bag cleaned up.
There's probably not very many convenient places to put it. That sounds a good idea to me.
Let me get my scoop. Get your scoop. Let's get it over with. Now say again, Bob, you want that, I don't have a scoop. I don't even have a rake. They're both gone, huh?
Yep.
Here's your rover sampler.
Yep.
They both fell off when that thing opened.
Yep.
Here's the full cord tube we can't forget.
Yeah, oh, that goes in,
the room for it?
Yeah, why don't you get that scoop off and I'll put it over here in 4. I mean, in 7.
We're going to get this SESC now and get out of the way, Bob.
Roger, we agree with that.
Okay. Minus V, yeah? You want it in front of the minus V foot pad?
Roger, put them underneath where you probably had the solar side of the cosmic ray experiment there. Between the SES, between the foot pad and the outlet doors there.
Hi, DBA.
Go ahead.
The fact that they're making this a two-man task is costing us a little bit of time.
Yep.
Cool. I got about an inch to go. Okay. Give me a minute, fill it up.
Right, tell me CDR got a good seawater start.
Okay, good.
Let's say again that point.
You just saying your speed water's up.
Okay. Both your feed waters are up about 17, so things look good.
Thank you. Keep that white thing off for me. Yeah. Here, let me get the... There you go. Great pictures.
Copy that. Okay, which SCV is that going in, Jack?
Number 5.
Okay, copy that.
Okay, the SCV's in, the SCV's at 5. Is that what you asked?
Yeah.
Short cannon 5.
So the short cannon SCV.
Okay,
and while you're doing
it, don't you want to get this?
Remember all on inventory, so the stuff as it comes off the rover, and where you put it over there with a footpad, we can keep track of it.
Okay, I've got, we've got the big bag, bag 7, bag 5, bag 4 at the footpad.
I tell me you were predicting 7 plus.
Copy that. We also got SCP 3 with the local Bennett on the rover. Do you have any? Yeah, you have some of those today.
We emptied those into 5.
Okay, copy that.
Okay, Bob, the gravimeter's on the surface. And you want a gravity reading and a bias reading, is that correct?
All right, we'll get the grav first. Copy that.
Okay, Bob, the gravimeter's on the surface. And you want a gravity reading and a bias reading, is that correct?
All right, we'll get the grav first.
Okay, Bob, mark it. Where am I?
Copy that.
What'd you do with the... Okay. Gravimeter. You got another big rock over here from the, it's in my foot pan. That's from Station 9, right? Yeah. That's what I told them. Station 9, I got a football-sized rock that I put it in there. So we literally lost one clamp. See what we've got left on here.
Yeah, Capcom, tell them they don't really need to worry about those clamps here.
Flight EVA.
Right.
I think we better tell them about those cameras.
Okay,
these football sized
rocks.
Before
looks like it might be
gold-coated. If he follows his checklist, he'll take a mag off the camera.
Yeah, it might have a shatter cone or two on it.
Okay, Jack.
Okay, I'll keep you. I don't know what you're focused on.
And,
but here's his rock.
And, Jack, we're making plans here to change the camera usage at the end of the EVA here. And we're going to let you take the commander's camera out to the outset and take a few photos which people think we need. And Dean's going to take your camera out and document the geophone when he deploys it. We will not deploy it for the long-term experiment, however. And we'll bring both back and carry them to the ETB when we get done.
Okay. Okay, we got to reverse the rules of the cameras here. While you're getting there, we got to drop our harnesses. Let me, before you take this, are you going to start loading ETP yet or not?
Well, I'm just about there.
Okay, I'll be right with you.
YDVA.
Good.
Might mention the scissors and, again, the clamps to go in the ETB, which is different from the checklist.
What clamps you talking about?
It's the ones that's on the fender. They want them back.
Who wants them then?
Prep. DVA prep. Post. I'm sorry, EVA post. YDVA.
Go ahead.
I understand those clamps are to be used on the utility lights during rendezvous. I think it was originally suggested by John Young that we do bring them back.
Okay, Bob, I've got the Cosmic Ray and the ETB. Okay, Bob, I've got the Cosmic Ray and the ETB.
Roger, copy that. Been in there all along, hasn't it?
Yep. Mag, Foxtrot, or Franny, I guess we changed it to. Mag, Donna, the DSEA, Mag, Echo, Mag, Linda. Mag Mary, we're through the 500.
Roger, we're through the 500.
Jack, we're in the Cosmic Ray. You put that in ETP already?
Yeah, okay.
I don't like the 500 working anymore anyway.
It's working,
that's
right
how I used it, yeah.
There
it is. Okay, film cycle. Three times. This way, man. Karen is in.
Copy that. That sounds like all of them to us.
And there are 200 cameras.
Roger.
Solid, I'm reading 670-010-701.
670-010-701. Okay, copy that. We're ready for a bias, Gene.
Okay. Bias, and it is flashing.
Roger, mark that.
Okay, let me take a look around. Jack?
Yeah.
Was that the bag in there?
Yes, it's over here on the Mason.
Okay. We don't need those anymore.
Yeah, confirm.
You come loose on the, you come loose on the right.
Like now.
Make pictures for you.
We can get that when we come back from the altar. So
yeah, as long as we don't throw any of the gear away, we need.
Okay, so we'd like to leave the we'd like to leave the core and the handle and the extension handle here, right?
And the hammer.
Come on,
you don't,
huh?
On the hammer, do
you? You don't have to get it around those hoses and everything. See if you can do it.
Works a lot better than the simulation, doesn't it?
They won't find the other one. Stand by.
It's the only fallacy. They're not even watching this. Come over and watch me, Ed. Hold me. Let me have it.
Hey,
man, move over that way. He can't do okay. Did you see me? Here it comes off.
Right.
Dodge your camera if you can see me.
Dodge, we can
take
see
it too
you.
Long. Just take it off. Is it off? Let's go.
That is almost
okay.
That's the case, Roger.
Jack, wait a minute before. Hey, Bob, are we going to need those other core tubes?
We'd like to have you leave the two core tubes and the extension handle and the hammer and a, I suppose, a core cap dispenser here. We get back in time from doing all our appointed tasks at the VIP site and at the ALSEP. We'll try and drive a double core here. End things up with a bang.
Don't leave it there. We'll play games with the extension handle, but that's all right. Okay, let me set them over here. Where am I? Okay, the big bag, all those. Don't need the other
guys. Leave your extension handles when the pallet came open.
Yes, but I can still drive a core with the hammer if we need to.
Okay, copy that.
I think. Yeah, one went with the rig and one went with the scoop. Okay, Bob, as I read down that page, it looks like we got it. The EKB check, I think we had four mags in there and the DSEA and the maps and the cosmic ray.
I'm ready to go to the VA.
Come on back here, Matt. Come on back here, Matt. I didn't realize you were going out there quite so soon. Well, I just looked to see where it is. Here, what'd you do with that, how about this one? You got it? What was that up in one of my footbands?
I put it in the big bag.
Okay. Here we go, Jack.
Here's one here.
Here, all right?
Yeah. Let me get something real good, Peter.
Okay.
Flight up.
Very good.
Go ahead.
Is he going to take the UHT out with him, the Alpha side?
You hold it.
Okay.
UHT?
Yeah. He has something to push on the LSQ with.
There's a UHT out there.
Okay. Yeah, I think it's still out there. Okay, fine.
About over here. Up there over here. Get that background. Yep. Houston, before we close out our EVA, we understand that there are young people in Houston today who have been effectively touring our country, young people from countries all over the world, effectively touring our country, had the opportunity to watch the launch of Apollo 17, hopefully had an opportunity to meet some of our young people in our country, and we'd like to say, first of all, welcome, and we hope you enjoyed your stay. Second of all, I think probably one of the most significant things we can think about when we think about Apollo is that
EVA, Jack Costi on the UHT, so we'd like to make sure that it's out there, because
you
don't
need it. A challenge of the future. The door is now cracked, but the promise of that future lies in the young people, not just in America, but the young people all over the world, learning to live and learning to work together. In order to remind all the peoples of the world, in so many countries throughout the world, that this is what we all are striving for in the future, Jack has picked up a very significant rock, typical of what we have here in the Valley of Torres Litro. It's a rock composed of many fragments of many sizes and many shapes, probably from all parts of the moon, perhaps billions of years old. But a rock of all sizes and shapes, fragments of all sizes and shapes, and even colors that have grown together and become a cohesive rock, outlasting the nature of space, sort of living together in a very coherent, very peaceful manner. When we return this rock, or some of the others like it to Houston, we'd like to share a piece of this rock with so many of the countries throughout the world. We hope that this will be a symbol of what our feelings are, what the feelings of the Apollo program are, and a symbol of mankind that we can live in peace and harmony in the future. A portion of a rock will be sent to the representative agency or museum in each of the countries represented by the young people in Houston today. And we hope that they will, that rock and the students themselves will carry with them our good wishes, not only for the new year coming up, but also for themselves, their countries, and all mankind in the future. Put that in the big bag, you know, in the big bag.
I like
to we salute you, promise of the future.
We thank you for your sentiments and your interest.
And now, let me bring this camera around. To commemorate, not just Apollo 17's visit to the Valley of Torres Litro, but an everlasting commemoration of what the real meaning of Apollo is to the world, we'd like to uncover a plaque that has been on the leg of our spacecraft that we have climbed down many times over the last 3 days. And I'll read what that plaque says to you. First of all, it has a picture of the world, two pictures, one of the North America and one of South America. The other covers the other half of the world, including Africa, Asia, Europe, Australia,
covers the North Pole and the South Pole. In between these two hemispheres, we have a pictorial view of the moon. A pictorial view of where all the Apollo landings have been made. So that when this plaque is seen again by others who come, they will know where it all started. The words are, here man completed his first exploration of the moon, December 1972 AD. In the spirit of peace in which we came, be reflected in the lives of all mankind. It's signed Eugene A. Sermon, Ronald E. Evans, Harrison H. Schmidt, and most prominently, Richard M. Nixon, President of the United States of America. This is our commemoration that will be here until someone like us, so some of you who are out there who are the promise of the future, come back to read it again, and to further the exploration and the meaning of Apollo.
Gene Lee in Houston, copy that and echo your sentiments. And Dr. Fletcher is here beside me. I'd like to say a word to the two of you.
Dean and Jack, I've been in close touch with the White House, and the President has been following very closely your absolutely fascinating work up there. He'd like to wish you Godspeed as you return to Earth. And I'd like to personally second that. Congratulations. We'll see you in a few days. Over.
Thank you, Dr. Fletcher. We appreciate your comments, and we certainly appreciate those of the President. And whether it be civilian or military, I think Jack and I would both like to give our salute to America. And Dr. Fletcher, if I may, I'd like to remind everybody, I'm sure something they're aware of, but this valley of history has seen mankind complete its first evolutionary steps into the universe, leaving the planet Earth and going forward into the universe. I think no more significant contribution has Apollo made to history. It's not often that you can foretell history, but I think we can in this case. And I think everybody ought to feel very proud of that fact. Thank you very much.
I'll see you in a little bit.
Okay, babe, let's go to the Okay, Bob, I owe you a bias reading. Okay, babe, let's go to the Okay, Bob, I owe you a bias reading.
Okay, or you can get it later. There's no hurry on that. And we're off to the LSEP.
Yeah, I'm going to give it to you right now.
Okay, ready to copy. I presume you have a UHP out of the LSEP, Jack.
That's firm. 337-417-101. 337-417-101.
Okay, copy that.
Are you through with this?
Sure are, Mike.
That's affirmative, Richard.
Roger.
Cop.
Roger, we're through with it.
Be kind, be kind. Well, I love it, and I'm sure you did a good job.
We're not through with you, Gene, so don't throw yourself too far.
No, sir. I just don't want to hit old Challenger there. That was unkind. You get the javelin. That was unkind.
Roger, Gene.
I hit throw as far as I could.
Three times the parabola for that, then we have one excellent measurement of G on the moon now.
Yeah, I didn't catch you a pendulum, but I don't know what I would, Bob. Okay, I'm gonna have to take you up to the bit side.
Okay, we're ready for that.
Did you concur?
Okay.
Flight deck calls for another bias reading.
I think you have to get it yourself.
Yeah, let me make sure I got everything. Okay. Pallet that's always in my way.
I think we are going to have one of those tomorrow, Jack, so we get away with that. We hope we're not going to have one of those tomorrow.
Rob, we're maximizing our efforts, so just bear with us. Jack's going to be in about 30 seconds, and I'm on the ladder. Calling some stuff up now.
Right, Johnny. Okay, we want to remind them to leave press reg A closed during the
pre-press
procedure.
Well, we're not. I just don't want you to.
I know.
Okay.
There, guys.
Okay.
Hi, DBA. Make a note of that. Press reg A, we want to leave that closed during the repress. Go ahead, DBA.
Okay, to save the city office some emergency, if he can just verify that we have three SCVs, the big bag,
okay.
And the con flux on the port, we're in good shape.
Okay, I don't think there's any question about verifying the bags.
You're not going to like this, we're going to get this one first, because I got to fly
in. It's a little bit of a that I wouldn't worry about it.
Oh, hang there. I've got it.
Got
oh, that's
it.
A heavy bag.
That is heavy, babe. Let me tell you that's heavy. Okay.
Next.
Yep, can you read that one? Now I'll step it in further.
Okay.
One more coming at you.
Okay.
Tilting up right now.
Go ahead. Okay, next.
Keep tilting up at you.
Got it.
Okay.
Okay, next. Okay, Bob, we've got up here. Big bag, three SRCs and a neutron flux.
Okay, and we gather an ETB is coming up with two cameras in it. Okay, and we gather an ETB is coming up with two cameras in it.
ETB next. Got an ETB? Yeah. ETB has two cameras.
Okay, and you guys say farewell to the moon. We're looking at the Earth down here. Will you guys return pretty soon?
Okay.
Okay,
you're going to have to push that. Okay, let me do it. That's right. I'll wait till you're ready. Okay. Make it. Yeah, I got it. Okay, let me get the other thing in here.
Bob, this is Gene, and I'm on the surface. And as I take man's last step from the surface, back home for some time to come, but we believe not too long into the future, I'd like to just let what I believe history will record, that
America's challenge of today has forged man's destiny of tomorrow. And as we leave the moon and Taurus Littoral, we leave as we came, and God willing, as we shall return with peace and hope for all mankind. Godspeed to crew of Apollo 17.
Roger, Dino. Thank you very much.
Bob, I am up on the ladder, and I'm going to be going through the hatch.
Okay, I'm fixing to turn the camera off.
All right.
Gene, I got to get out of your way.
Yep. Here I come.
Come on in.
That's what good is?
Well, dirty.
Yep.
Okay, keep her down. Buttons. Come towards me. Well, there you go. Okay, you got it.
Okay.
Let me look at this.
Just little blisters on it, is all. You can kind of peel it off with your fingers.